I just say yes now. I stop fighting him. You can't win with God. He's going to do what he wants to do anyway. So, to all you women, you look beautiful. No matter who you are, what age you are phenomenal and created for a purpose. You have work to do. My mentor said, when you have a job, you go, you hate it. You talk about everybody, they're like, I can't wait to get out of here. Is it 5 o'clock yet? What time is lunch? Do I have to go back? But when you do your work, you don't need an alarm clock. You wake up excited. You can barely sleep because there's so much passion and vision in you. There's work that you know you have to do, and you are excited about it. It's like, it's time to go home. Wait, I can't go home yet. I got a couple more things to do. That's when you're doing your work. And as a phenomenal woman, you are created to do work. Work in the community, work in your families, and work in the kingdom. So today I come in, and I'll just give you a backdrop. So for those who do not know me, I'm Stephanie Gilchrist. Let me give you a quick synopsis. Stephanie Gilchrist, husband and I own Ryan's Chair Barbershop Beauty Salon in Longwood. Worked for the Youngstown Business Incubator, run a women entrepreneurship program, and just started a youth entrepreneurship program with my sidekick, Tanisha, over there. That's the gist of who I am. So, I said, if anybody follows me on social media, for my friends on social media, what are my hashtags?
And what else?
And what else? And I got one more. You called me that this morning, I seen you.
I said Wonderwall.
Ah, okay. I was going to say, you my sister. You know that. And if anybody told me, she changes everything. It's something that God has given to me thanks to the Greenlee family, Sister May. If you follow Greenlee, yeah. She did an event, and I just took that, and now I LLC'd it all of that. So more to come on that. But I also decided to do Wonder Woman 21 as a hashtag. Because when I was reading about Wonder Woman 21 before I watched the movie, I said, well, wait a minute. Man, she's living out her dream. She got wings of gold. She got wings of gold. And everybody know gold is a precious metal, right? It's valuable. But to get to gold, you have to go through pressure. There's some things that you have to endure, and Madonna talked about that resilience, right? So she had wings of gold. But guess what? She had two enemies she still had to fight. So no matter what level Wonder Woman goes to, if you follow the series, it's always new adversaries. The higher you go, the more demons, the more people you have to fight against, right? Because there's something in you that's so great. And it can't help but continue to grow. And the people around you can't always go with you. So sometimes they'll turn into your enemies or your foes. So when I was thinking about it, I said, okay, God, I don't know, you know, what to do, how you're going to lead me. I know what I'm going to talk about, Wonder Woman, because a lot of people have been waiting for me to say something about the Wonder Woman. So last night, I said, well, let me sit down and watch Wonder Woman 84. And when I typed in Wonder Woman 84, I said, I'm going to watch it again so I can prepare. But instead, I couldn't find it. I was like, why is this the devil so hot? But instead, you know what came up? Wonder Woman, Bloodlines. I said, oh, Bloodlines. Okay, let's talk about it. The Bloodlines. Then I look at the purple up here, and purple is a tie between blue and red, and we all know that red represents blood. And I think about the blood that runs through our veins, and not just our veins, but the veins of our community and our children. So I said, Wonder Woman Bloodlines, let me see what this is about. So if you've never seen the Wonder Woman Bloodlines, it's cartoon, it's animated. But what was deep about it is Princess Diana starts out with a man being under attack, underwater. It's these demons coming after him. And out of nowhere, here comes a woman. She goes into the water and she snatches the demon attacking him and she snatches him up. And brings him back to her place. And the place that they lived in, if you know any of my Wonder Woman, their village was ran by her mother, the queen. And Princess Diana brings a man into a woman's kingdom. Whoa. What are you doing? We don't do that. But she said to her mother, there's something greater about this thing that I have. I can't stay in this kingdom with you. I have to go because his kingdom's under attack, called Earth. So I must go to Earth with this man, Stephen. And he was cute, even in the anime, he was cute. But she said, I will give up my kingdom to go to my purpose. I will give up my title to do what I know I was purposed to do. I am going away. Her mother even pulled out a sword. They had a little fight. Mother and daughter. And the daughter hit the ground. It was a, and her mother could have killed her. But instead she said, if you go, you can't come back. And you will never get the crown. And she said, but my calling is greater than the title. So her mother walks away, spares her life, but her mother's crying because she's like, I just lost my daughter. How many of you have that in your life? When people you love don't get it, I got to walk away. You're not good for me. You can't come into my future. Because every time I look at you, you remind me of my yesterday. I am phenomenal. To be phenomenal means you're above board. Ain't nothing typical about you. You're in the wrong room if you think less of yourself than you ought. Because you were called to something great. It's not by happenstance that you're here. It is designed for you to be here. Madonna kicked us off with it. What would our community be without Madonna? What would our black girls look to when they see 21 and my cousin who works at 21 and Sydney who's at 21? Wouldn't it be if we didn't have Madonna? Yes. And we said we love you. Yeah. And I don't care how crazy you go on post, they need it. And we always support her, got your back. Because she's a phenomenal woman who, when we thought she would have left, her father said, no, not her. I'll take her place. The sword was there. And he said, not so. She has what? Work to do. So, now let's close for you. Whew. So, Princess Diana, and you know I love Princess Diana, but the real life Princess Diana, aka Princess Di. She rescues this man. She comes to Earth. Needless to say, years pass. She's loving Earth. And the people on Earth said, what kind of woman is this? She is slaying enemies. She is taking folks out. Who is she? And they were like, oh, we got it. She is now called Wonder Woman. Because there's none like her that we've ever seen that can fly, jump up in the air, flip over buildings, and knock down walls, and men that are standing at her as giants, she's slain. Wonder Woman comes in, and she begins to see a little girl in distress. And the little girl is overtaken by Villainy Inc. We all know Villainy Inc. That's Dr. Evil, Dr. Whoever. That's all the evil folks in the comic. The girl, Vanessa, is taken over. And she's feeling guilty, and she's like, what can I do? I gotta win her. But Vanessa goes so far out and so far taken by the enemy, she doesn't know how am I going to get this girl back. She's fighting the girl, because she's like, this is not who you are. How many of you are out here fighting for your bloodline to tell your children, your grandchildren, your nieces, your nephews, the kid next door, because our city has seen so much violence this year, unnecessarily with our youth. How many of you are taking the time to say, no, not in this bloodline, not in the city of Youngstown, we will not have that in for me? I don't feel like turning off this bottle. It's not that we can't do it, some things we just don't have to do. Because God gave us that choice. So be all you want to be as a woman. Because I'm not male bashing. But what I will say to you is that how could it be that with the men in place, and I love them, keep doing what you do, we're still not seeing the results. We're still not seeing change in our education system. We're still not seeing change in our city. Wonder Woman, phenomenal woman. Where are you? Now is the time for you to stand tall, stand up, and do what you were called to do. If you could do one thing as far as change, let me see, let me put it like this, what one of my mentors says. He says it like this. Can you do anything to make your life worse? Yes or no? That's a yes or no. Can you?
Yeah.
Can you do anything to make your life worse? Next question. What can you do to make your life better? Can you make your life better? So guess what? Choose you this day. What do you want? What dream do you have? What vision do you have? I push people. I was pushing my makeup artist today. I know he's like, why is she asking me all these questions? I'm like, is this it for you? Just stand behind a chair and don't make up. He said, I love what I do. And I said, oh, he's still not getting it. Okay, so is this all your, what else? So are you satisfied with all the products you use? Yeah, pretty much. If I could do, you know, I had used this idea. Where's the innovator in you? We were all born to create something. This is what happens. Let us make men in our own image after our own likeness. Let there be, 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 let there be. He said, let us create man / woman in our own image. And then he said, let there be, let there be, let there be. Do you know you have that same power? So let there be, let there be, let there be. The only hindrance is that somebody lied to you and told you you weren't worth it. And I want to dispel that for you today. I want you to know that you can decide that you want to go impact the world with your gift. All you have to do is change a lifestyle, a location, the people you hang around. If the people you hang around are not elevating you, you're the wrong crowd. And let me say this too. I had to start finding women, one is in this room now, I'm not going to call her out, who could mentor me and who I could look up to, who has more than I do. Because now I'm accountable. I had an aunt that for years, you know, she was in a magazine for Essence, a few years, like, that was like 2005. And she had to break it down to the family, like, so I'm in the Essence magazine, Beyonce's on the cover. And I just need to let y'all know I am rich, and that's what the article's about. I'll retire at 44 rich. I said, well, wait a minute. This been in my bloodline all this time, and I've never heard from it. So that's what I do now. Hey, Auntie, I'm checking in. Okay, I'm on your account. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, yes, ma'am. And you need to do this, and you do that, and you need to, yes, ma'am. Because I'm looking at my future as did Wonder Woman and bloodlines. What they didn't know the whole time, the enemy was plotting to come to her home town and tear it up because they wanted the power that all the women had and the technology that the women had in her hometown. So her leaving going to earth what we didn't realize was only for her to find out what the plan was so she could combat it. And then check this out. Everyone else got turned to stone against while fighting the enemy except her, because she already knew the tools they were about to use against her. So you leaving that place of comfort, get out. Move. Because you're holding a key that will change the city's direction, the direction of your family, the direction of your kids, the direction of your grandkids. Poverty is not for me. I don't like it. I hate being broke. If you do, God bless you. Because Bob said the poor will always be among you. So God bless me so I can always be a blessing to you or to the poor. But I don't like that when I see need, I can't meet the need. I want to be that chick that I'm like, what's your fundraiser? $1,200. Girl, here's a check. Figure out, get a bigger goal. That is the phenomenal woman. So Lord's vision here to promote and push us as women. There's no need to be like, well, I could have did this. No, we all are doing this together. Because we're in the community, just like Wonder Woman. It was not just one woman fighting the battle to save their city. They were all on the line like this. So women, get in position, stretch back, and release whatever gift or call that's on your life. So thank you so much for having me, Lori. I appreciate it. I hope you got something out of it. And I want to declare and decree over every one of you that you are the head and not the tail. You're above and not beneath. God has called you to greatness. If you've ever been in a situation where you're feeling hostage, can you think? Where you feel like you're stuck and can't move. Every woman that's been in this room that's ever been abused, verbally or physically, no judgment, I need you to stand. Any woman who feels like she's not smart enough or good enough, I need you to stand. That you don't have what it takes to be successful, I need you to stand. If you believe in the power of prayer, raise your hand. Your right hand is right hand means power. And right now, I just speak a word over your life. And I declare and decree at this very moment that the peace of God will overshadow you. And every lie that a man has told you, from being ugly to not worthy enough, from neglect from a mother or a father, not receiving the love that you deserve, I speak a healing over your life. A healing over your mind. I release a newness and a freshness for vision and dreams to come forth. I speak prosperity over your lives. That it will not just change your life, but generations to come. I declare and decree wholeness. And I come against the evil spirits and principalities that will try to
created you to be. Let joy like a river flow from the front of this room to the back. And God, let your glory and your presence reside in each and every hand lifted at this very moment. And even when they come in here tomorrow, let the glory of the Lord saturate them. Let their businesses prosper. Let them, Lord God, get more money in the next 6 months than they ever made in the last few years of their career. Give them vision, witty ideas, technologies, Lord God. Give them what they need, not just for them, but for your sake. And for the sake of the city and for the sake of the kingdom. And we will give you glory. We will bless you. Bless Lori, Father God, in this endeavor. Continue to keep her, cover her, give her wisdom and knowledge. And we thank you because the devil's a liar and he cannot have her. He cannot have what she has. He cannot have her health, her mind, or her finances. And we declare it is so over her and her entire house. In Jesus' name, amen.